Today I'm going over my Youthberg deck profile. If you still want a beautiful playmat, go to zerodamagegaming.com. This pretty one is available right now. You can use code SOLEMN for a discount. We also have backpacks, which is something we did in the past, but now we're trying again. I've actually been rocking this one for like 5 years now, and it's still holding strong. This design actually isn't available anymore, but many others are. I personally use this to bring like a couple decks, my playmat, and then a binder, you know, for traits and stuff like that. So it's nice, lightweight, love it. Once again, use the code SOLEMN for a discount. If you still need Vanguard cards, however, go to 50cards.shop and use the code SOLEMN. He's actually the reason I have this beautiful DSR, so oh, beautiful. So for the profile now, I wanted to do something a little bit different because everyone already knows the typical list. You know, you have your two shield girl, you have your maple. It's like, okay, this is the same list a billion times. So I'm going to show you a slightly different one that I actually currently prefer. So starting off with the right deck, of course, we have our beautiful Youthberg, and then we have just 0-1-2. There's nothing special here. Then we have triple of this Youthberg Skyfall. Of course, that makes it 4 because persona riding is crucial, especially in this deck. It's even so crucial that I consider still to put a trial deck Youthberg, because it counts as a Skyfall Arms, in the ride deck. So that way you actually have 4 persona rides main decked, which ups your odds. Persona riding truly is so crucial, especially in this deck. The only weakness you will really feel when you play the trial deck version in your ride deck is that you won't get the discard to check top and, you know, fill your field or improve your hand like Skyfall has, but that payment for that might be worth it. Next, we got 4 Tempests, which is of course the most important card. At first, I was always trying to big brain this deck, going like, oh, maybe I should use Gust this turn. Oh, maybe I should do this. Maybe I should do that. I learned that whenever you're unsure, just go Tempest blindly. Don't even think. Like, Gust is usually gonna be the thing you do the very last. If you have the choice, you almost always go Tempest. And sometimes you'll be like, ah, but maybe Gust is interesting here. I gotta kind of think, you know, the pros and cons and blah, blah, blah. No, that's bullshit. It's almost always Tempest. Trust. The amount of tempo you gain from going Tempest is just incredible. And this deck grinds so much that it will more often lead to a win. Now, I understand where the mistake comes from, because sometimes you're like, wow, my hand is so small. I'm definitely dying next turn, so I should risk it all right now and go Gust. But Youthberg actually draws so much more than you may be thinking, that even though at the start of your turn, your hand is small and you're like, oh, I'm going to go Gust, it's going to get way bigger. So yeah, sometimes Gust is better, but when in doubt, spam Tempest. This card is insane. Now, of course, I still play triple Gust. Reason being, of course, we do need to have a Revolt form in our hand. Whenever we don't, this deck sucks ass. It's literally unplayable. So we always have to have one. I know some people play like 4 of this, or they might even play one of the trial deck one. To me, that's wrong, because the trial deck one just feels really bad. And then this deck is also like prone to having very shit shield when it comes to our hand, because we're playing so many 3s in the main deck. So for that reason, 3 here feels good. And again, this is so much worse than Tempest. Sometimes if you're forced into this too often, you're losing anyway. Now, where this deck differs is this card. Most people are not playing Carbre, but to me, this card is absolutely insane. When I first read this card, I actually thought, hey, this seems really good in premium. And when a card in Overdress is good enough to be good in premium, that is saying something. So Carbre essentially says CB1, Soul Blast 1, check top 3, and if there's a grade 2 or less, you may call it to field, and if it's a grade 3 or higher, you can add it to your hand. So this kinda does what Schneisel does, in that you could find your persona ride or your revolve form, but when it fails, it will still build you field. This makes it, in my opinion, far more interesting than Schneisel. Now, I'm not saying to not play Schneisel, I'm still playing 2 Schneisel, and if you want to swap these numbers, where it's like 3 Schneisel, 2 Carbre, that's fine too, if you're like super afraid of not having persona. But what this does allow us to do is go second much better. If you go first, usually you do not have the CB to do Tempest, Schneisel, and our grade 2 add back. That's very rare unless your opponent, you know, credits you out of the game. But going second, you often have a bunch of CB, and being able to then push back is huge. So Carbre really allows us going second to just build a field out of nowhere and then just blast our opponent. Sometimes you may even sack a little, and then your ride line might randomly find a Carbre, and then a Carbre might find something else, and you might just poop a field out of nowhere. Now, I do understand that this does not give the power boost that Schneisel does, so I do still want to play it. Ideally, I want to see 1 at 1 point, so I have the good numbers. But just in general, like at most points in the game, except for, you know, the end, I really prefer seeing a Carbre. Again, though, if you're missing persona, right, the deck sucks, so Schneisel is still really solid. It's just that when you Schneisel, pay CB, check top 5 and find nothing, you feel awful. So it's a bit of a balancing act. I'm really liking this currently. Now, for grade 1s, we have for Wayward Angel. This is, of course, the way we build a free field. We just discard one for our grade 3 ride, and then we get this out. We discard it for our Skyfall Arms, and then we also have a free card. We could discard it for Gust, and then we also have a free card. This just builds our field out of nowhere. And Carbre kinda is like doing what Wayward does whenever you're not drawing Wayward, which is also something I noticed. This deck is like a puzzle, and you're trying to draw specifically Persona Ride, a Revolform, preferably Tempest, Wayward, and Sequana. And when you don't, you feel awful, right? However, if you're not drawing Wayward, but you are finding Carbre, that issue is already solved. And beyond that, Carbre can also find Sequanas, which is also really solid. So this card kind of like glues more things together than you may think. So that is our 4 Wayward. Next, I have 4 Sequana. Like I said, we want to have this at all time because it's going to give us drive checks, and that's the only way we have pressure on our second Vanguard attack. Also, a little trick, if you don't know, you can actually use this to have Gust with 2 drive checks, because this card specifically says increase or decrease its drive to 1, and Gust says gain a drive. So Skyfall will reduce the drive to 0, then Sequana will put it to 1, and then Gust will go plus 1 drive. Now for the final card, and I do have to give credit here to Nuno, our world champion for V Premium actually, I was first playing the regular deck. And what we noticed is, if you just play a regular game going first, you can never use all of your CB to truly get all the value. You know, you can't have a Revolform Tempest plus a Schneisel plus an add back from your ride line. It's 3, and in general, you're gonna have 2. Because you can't spend CB freely to really push your opponent, and if you're calling rear guards early, now they will deny you and you definitely are not able to use it. You're really losing a lot of tempo in this deck. So what he really liked to play was a Nucleate. And at first I hated this card. I was like, nah, man, this feels wrong. But the more we played and the higher level we kind of started playing, the more obvious it became how crucial this card is if going first you want insane tempo. So if you disagree with this choice, take it up with our world champion. But I really, really like this. It also gives a 5k buff to the thing we ride. So the second swing is now going to have the number Schneisel was supposed to give, but without the awkward attack pattern of having to attack first with Schneisel. Also, going second, we can truly go ham with Schneisel and Carbre. If you recall the normal way to play Youth, you were always kind of tippy-toeing around having to activate Schneisel because you're like, damn, I'm going to deny myself. This game is going to go long. Tempest is going to require a CB. Kind of have to watch out here. Enucleate is just like, nah, spam him. You know, Carbre, Carbre, Schneisel, Schneisel, grade 2, add back Tempest, Tempest, who cares? You know you will get it back easily anyway. And also, if your opponent doesn't know what build you're on, they might try to deny you, and if you then enucleate them, suddenly it's like, wow, nice, you lost all tempo. Next, for perfect guards, we have, of course, triple of the cool one, and then one of the order. The order is just insane, I don't know what to tell you. Now for triggers, I'm just playing our 8 crit. Interestingly though, I am playing vanilla crit specifically. This deck has infinite soul, so like, I don't really care about anything, you know? Prison also isn't the real deck to me. If you're on this deck, you have so much soul anyway, you can just bail out your entire prison. Like, I don't care. You're gonna put 7 cards in my prison, I'm gonna go like, oh, I just so happen to have 7 soul, let's go. So I don't really need the soul charge crits that much. And what's gonna happen sometimes is that your ride line, which checks stop and then might call to field, and your Carbre, which checks stop and then might call to field, will sometimes just call triggers. You know, sometimes you'll just get unlucky. Then being forced to call a 4K trigger is awful. So for that reason, I really wanted the 5Ks, similar to the Gravidia World deck I topped with. Though this argument is a little different, because Gravidia World was because I was actually committing it manually, whereas here it's sometimes just being forced to commit it. Then triple front trigger, because this deck already plays around deck outs quite a bit, so we don't want to like randomly kill ourselves with draws. And also fronts are really good in this deck because our rear guards actually aren't that scary. Like, their numbers are kind of iffy. It's really only when you have a Wayward with a Schneisel in front, and then you might have a Persona, that the numbers start getting good. So fronts really, really help in the deck. Then we have one over trigger, you know, our auto win. The worst part about this deck is that it's a Keter deck, so our over trigger sucks balls. I wish this was a brand gate deck so we had like the random auto wins, but alas. And then finally we have our 4 heals. So this is my current Youth Berk list. I hope you enjoyed it very much. Again, if you want a beautiful new playmat, go to zerodamagegaming.com and use the code SOLEM for a discount. Also still have backpacks. If you need any cards, go to 50cards.shop and use the code SOLEM, and I will see you soon. Ciao.